Welcome, drivers, to Doug and Captain K play Horizon Chase Turbo. I have that campaign! Nothing says winter like summer. Really? It's just these races? Really? Huh. So it looks like I'm not going around the world.
Well, there.
And it's just... Really? It's just this car? The releases will go back to normal next week, not this week. You have no idea. First of all, like, the power kept going out of my apartment complex the other week. Add to that, this week, I had to leave early for work because of my school teaching job. They literally sent me an email talking about how, really, I have to get their tokens here? Okay. Guess that means I gotta retry. Wait, because how many laps do I have? I had three laps, right? You had three laps.
I would think so, yeah.
It's okay, so left is the first best ones. Anyway, whoa! This is new music. I'm okay with this. Anyway, so like I was saying, first of all, I had to leave early from my day job because of school telling me to do some new thing of professional development on top of the professional development that I had to do. And as far as... Then they're telling me to, like, do webinars and shit. And I'm like, what kind of webinars? I'm teaching IT. What the... What kind of webinars are we talking about? And they're just... Not only that, they were like, oh, if you have to pay any money, we'll pay you, we'll reimburse you up to $250. I'm like, okay, cool, but what the fuck am I... And then they're talking about, like, mandatory bi-quarterly meetings. Which, guess what? You want to know when the first meeting is?
When?
Monday at 8:30 p.m. Oh, no, at 8 p.m. Because, did I miss a batch of points? Whatever. They want me to be there from like 6 p.m. Till we run from 6 till 7. And what that is, I'm gonna be at my day job, and I'm like, what?
Yeah, it's not really a thing you can do.
I can't really control that. If they told me like X amount of weeks in advance, then I'd roll with those punches. But like, how the hell am I supposed to? If they told me like a week or two in advance, I'd plan around that. But literally, it's a fucking pricks. Okay, let's do this. God, I really wish I could change the fucking color. Okay, the shoreline music isn't new. Well, no, it isn't. Okay, so I gotta pay attention to the fucking coinage. Because of course I have to. That's weird. I wonder what happens if I get all the coins now. It's not a boost. I can tell you, it's not an extra boost. I can tell you that right now. Or else those blue coins would be purple. Okay, so right side. What else is there? What other? I see you. No! It's okay, I got two more laps to turn it around. So, I'll take it so long as I get the coinage. Unless I lose. Here's what I consider to be a loss if I'm not first place. Because I'm pretty sure that there's an achievement that unlocks once you get first place. Just like the additional car you unlock if you get first place in World Tour. And it's default. Where the hell are those goddamn... Thank you. Cool. Now I can pass this dude with impunity. Alright. Now I can just boost. Fuck. It's okay. We're still good. We got one more lap. And I got two more cars that are in front of me. It's not like they're fucking impossible to catch. All I need to do is boost. Shit. I might have to restart these. Because I'm running. I'm almost out of fuel. Oh god, there's only one fuel spot. And I'm out of boost. Make it! Oh god, I don't think I can make it! Come on! Almost! Oh, this is so harrowing. This is ridiculously harrowing. No! No! Woo! Oh! Bad enough I can't do an episode of Ninja Gaiden or Ultra or Condemned, but I can damn sure do an episode of the once a month playlist as well as, as well as your plays, Captain. Good lord! This was Hollywood. Okay. This is new. This is a new stage. Dude, we're in Hollywood. You can virtually smell the pretentiousness. Fuck! Okay, right side. Two laps? Oh, shit.
Oh, dear.
God damn it. Ninja! Okay. No! Okay, right, left, right, left. Remember that. Right, left, right, left. Because I need those coins. Gotcha. Okay, so at least I got extra boost. No! Oh, right, we only have two laps, so right, left, right, left. God damn it, stop missing all the fuel! Fucking... Okay, right, left, right, left. Unless they throw more coins my way. And... Okay, they didn't. That's good. Real good, but now that those two cars are hella in front of me. Okay, so right, what? God damn it! Left. Where's the coins? Right. Come on, where's the coins? And left. Some more coins to the left. Okay. Where are the coins? Where are the coins? What happened to the coins? Whatever, I still have enough. Well, did you see any more coins?
Mm-mm. Not as we were going to.
But
I mean, there obviously must be more.
Where? Oh, man.
Maybe it blends into something, and that's why we just didn't notice.
God damn it. Where did I miss the coins? Where did I miss the fucking coins? Ow. I'm calling this episode Failed Coin Hunt. Ridiculous. I want to know what I unlock if I get all the coins. Okay, so here's the first batch. And then the second batch is here. And then the third batch, we come... Oh, God, I missed it.
Oh, they're over there.
Yeah. So, okay.
That's kind of a hard... Because you're going to have to get over there and get right back.
Yeah, okay. All right. Well, at the very least, come on, get the gas. Gas. Give me all the gas. Fucking fossil fuel. Why the hell can't people use fucking electric cars? Teslas are...
Nobody wants to charge.
But, like, Teslas can clock in at, what, 300 miles or something?
Yeah, Teslas, for all their money, they're not considered the more reliable. Because everybody wants to try and reap their benefits. Usually it's like, oh, well, this mechanic thing.
I guess. But it's still like 300 miles at a clock-in Tesla.
Oh, yeah. There's a lot of electric cars
nowadays that technically could do more than they used to. And they're a decent choice to be able to do. It's just they know most people aren't going to go for it. And oil companies.
Oh, okay.
Oil companies are not going to be excited about you suddenly being like, yeah, we don't need your fossil fuels. So, of course, no one's going to promote to not do it because then oil companies have issues.
That's true. We can do this. Man, I can make it. Unless this dude's hiding another boost that I'm not aware of. Fuck. It's going to be down to the goddamn wire, isn't it? Shit, he's going to win. Nope. Okay, so right, left, right. For the coins. I can't believe it. Have any of you... God, nope. And for any of you that are like, oh, Doug, you're being hypercritical, I want first place, goddammit. Because that's what you unlock. Yeah, I need first place. First place is awesome. You know what's weird? I read that, like, it's better to get a bronze medal than silver. Psychologically speaking, that is. Because, like, if you're in third place, it's fine. But if you're in second place, you're beating yourself up a lot more.
But what about those people who are psychologically suffering because they got third place and they were beating themselves?
Apparently, it's not that bad. That's better than, they don't mind it. Like, it's so weird. Like, they honestly don't mind it.
That's strange.
Yeah, right?
I get that, you're not at the top, but I don't feel like there should be a significant difference between, oh, you're second versus, oh, you're third versus, like, you're sixth.
Just,
like, there's a reaction between those.
I guess. I just don't know. I just think it's weird. How the hell... I don't know how they're going to be okay with getting third over second place.
I mean, I guess from their viewpoint of a psychological stress level, I can see it. Because second place is going to create more burden over the fact that you knew you were close to first.
Yeah.
Whereas third, you know you weren't close, but you're still in an upper tier above everybody else, so you can kind of feel a little more complacent. But in terms of being relieved more than second place, that seems flawed. Because
I know!
If you made second place, you would automatically be happier than the third place person.
I know!
So why would you feel more relieved being the third place person, when if you had been second, you still would have appreciated more than being the third place person?
Again, I know. Hey, dude, preaching the goddamn choir. I just, that's the weirdest fucking, like.
Yeah. I can get it from the viewpoint of stress after the fact. I could get it. You'll feel a lot more relieved knowing you were third than second in the after fact, because as a second place person, you feel like you missed out on your first place choice, whereas your third place, you didn't have that expectation at first, so it's not like it's suddenly crushed. But in comparison to the second, it's dumb. Because, yeah, if you had the option to be second place over third place, you would take it. Like,
yeah, right?
No one's going to go, no. No, I won't. Well, okay, I'll slightly retract that. Because I was in band, and I was good at tuba, but I hated tuba, so I spitefully would not pass chair tests properly.
Oh, really?
No. Yeah, no, there was a lot. Like, I didn't want to be in the first band. I hated my instrument. I would constantly try and negotiate to switch instruments, and they would lie to me and be like, oh, yeah, if you learn this instrument, we'll let you switch. And I'd learn a different instrument, and they're like, oh, well, it's important during concert season, so you got to stay on the other one. And then you go into another year, and the same thing happens. So I learned to play various instruments to never play those instruments in the actual band, just so I could get out of playing my instrument. But... every so often they'd have chair tests, and I purposely sat around like chair five, because I wouldn't have to have as much responsibility as to be chair one and have to pay attention to playing my instrument that I don't like. But I'm not so in lower the tier that I'm in the terrible band that just plays like show tunes. Like, I can still play decent level music if I wanted to, and then not be an issue and not be like, oh, let's play Amazing Grace for our concert. But...
Oh, okay. So out of curiosity,
so that's Caleb's thing.
So out of curiosity, what other? I didn't know you tuba, but like, what other instruments did you captain?
Well, tuba was their main one they threw me on. I learned baritone. I learned the valve trombone because it is tricky to learn the slide placements just by sound and being able to move around.
Oh, okay.
Learned bass clarinet. I technically learned flute, but he still wouldn't let me get out of it because that particular band director was like, flute's too girly. Even though we had a male clarinetist, but okay, sure. no issues with him being over there in his short pants and stuff, but me being a flute, yes. That is the ultimate atrocity. But, yeah, so there's those mainly. I stumbled a little bit into bass guitar, but not so good as to actually perform like songs out my head. And there's a little bit of, I can play piano by ear, but it'll take me a little bit to reconstruct the songs.
Ah. Uh-huh.
So that's about the main thing. But yeah. No, that was always my issue with band, was I was vindictive towards it solely because it's like, I'm supposed to be enjoying this, and you just want me on this instrument. So I'm going to purposely play good enough so that we don't fuck up, but I'm not going to play at my full capacity so that we exceed. And so I would just sit there. Anytime there was a chair test that would move me, I would organize some situation to get moved back.
Oh, okay.
So if they bumped me up to like chair 3, I'd wait till someone below wanted to do a test and be like, I will move up in chair. And I'd be like, that's awesome. You can pass me. And then I would purposely underplay. And then
wow.
I would just slide back down the chair.
Captain K, everybody. He's a professional schemer. Again, just read K for treachery, and you will learn how to enact betrayal. And plan and scheme. I mean, I'm sorry. Plan, schemers, and the planners.
So, I mean, I am normally not a petty person. And I don't hold grudges, and I won't go out of my way to, like, cause problems. Unless you're clearly doing stuff just because you think I can't do it. If you feel like you're doing stuff to me because you have the advantage, no, I would go out of my way to figure out where I have to go. But if it's just happening, I'm perfectly fine with it because that's just the way things happen. If you're like, oh, well, you can't do this for this reason, and it's something that no one can control, I'm fine. You can't do it. But when it's the person is actually, you're the only one stopping me from doing what I'm wanting, and there's no reason for it, you just don't want me to do it. No, I'm gonna be a petty bitch. Like, I'm wholeheartedly, if you're standing in the way of something for me to do, and it's something important to me, and there's no reason for you to do it, like, there's no negatives to you at all.
Wait, no!
Do it!
I'm sorry.
Yes.
I'm sorry. Well, no, because I missed the coins.
I saw it as it happened.
Yeah, okay, so you were saying?
But I was just basically saying, if it's something that's beyond my control, I'm not going to be right. Like, if he had said, like, if there's a school rule or some crap, and that's why I can change his plans, I wouldn't have been a dick enough. Mm-hmm. I'd have been fine. I'd be like, okay, stop and listen, whatever. But when it's literally, I'm only on this instrument because you won't let me switch, and you know that I can play other instruments, and I've proven it, but you still won't let me switch. No, I'm going to be a dick. I'm going to go out of my way so that every time you think I'm going to do the best, I'm going to do the most mediocre I can. So that you can't be mad at me for doing the worst, but you damn well can't claim that I didn't put any out. So you sit at mediocre.
Captain K, be mediocre then. For those who are wondering what the hell that I was doing, that's literally a parody of I literally did a parody song on the old Army commercials, like, Army, be all that you can be. Before they switched that Army of One nonsense, and then they wised up and they were like, yeah, no, join the military.
Yeah. No, it used to be ridiculous, because it was all just like, oh, you're going to be amazing, you're going to be the most ultimate soldier, and then they started having issues in the world with soldiers breaking, and so that was kind of like, oh, you can just join us, you don't have to be the ultimate soldier.
Yeah, right? Oh, God. You think that's weird? There was this one commercial, and it was like, I forget which game was at college they were trying to promote. And they were like, they were showing off beta testers, like just playing video games or whatever. And they're like, I can't believe we get paid to do this. And I'm like, pretty much every game designer on the in the planet was just like, you fucking assholes. Nobody likes to test. You think anybody likes to test games? What the fuck is the matter with you?
I mean, when you're younger and you're first getting into games, it seems exciting until you do. And then you're like, oh, that's what you want.
Yeah.
Like, that's really, because I went through it before, because I went and tried the a tester for Squaresoft. And it was like, yeah, I went in all super excited because it's fucking Squaresoft. And then you get there and it's like, so play this and then tell us all the errors. Like, just, and then they didn't even really give you context. They're just like, whatever you think are errors, write them down. And then we'll compare it and see if they're really errors. So we weren't even really told what the errors were. They were just like, figure out what the problem was and then tell us that.
Ew.
Yeah, it's not a pleasant experience at all. I mean, yeah, you get to play the game and they leave you alone to do it. But it's shitty because anything that happens, you have to have a brief moment of, was that intended? Is that not intended? Is that possibly an issue with the programming? Is that collision? Is that name misspelled? Because I don't know this fucking character. That might be their name. Like, I don't know. Because that's the things you check. You check all the grammaticals, you check the punctuation, you check how. And it gets to a ridiculous point because if you aren't told the pretext of anything, you don't know what you're checking. And a lot of times they don't tell you. So you could be jumping over something that's an issue the whole time because you didn't realize it was an issue. You just thought it was part of the game.
Yeah.
Okay. So it's fun when you hear about it, but unless you're just in one of those companies where that game is so fucking fun it doesn't matter, like, no. It's a bother to do testing. It drains your soul and kind of makes you not want to play that game. Not necessarily all games, but the game you tested, you're kind of done.
Oh, God. Lord knows, like, people, if you're an aspiring game designer, let me put it to you this way. You would be so, if you're testing, like, for a game, and you're not tired of, like, and the final product comes out, and you're like, I still want to play this game. You are a fool. If you think that's good, if you think you can, like, retain the love, just all the shit you have to put up with in terms of testing, and then, like, you have the final product in your hands, and just like, dude, I don't want to look at you.
Yeah. Yeah. Unless it literally is your baby that you've been working on for years, and, like, you've been crunching, and you were eating fucking bologna sandwiches else every day, because you needed to do that to be able to get this work done.
I'm sorry, then, Captain. You do not diss bologna sandwiches. Bologna
cheese. That wasn't a diss. That's a cost efficiency.
Okay, then.
I'm like, that's what you do. You go buy meats and you make sandwiches at home. You can't afford to go eat out. You're a game designer, Butch.
Yeah.
What's this eat out money?
What's this eat out money?
That's why it's after a game does well you hear about all the partying and everything. You don't hear about it during it. That happened.
Yeah.
No one is going out being like, hey, let's booze it up tonight. Then tomorrow, let's come back and work on that engine. No. There is no one.
Fair enough. Hey, how much time do I have left?
Wholeheartedly, I'm not sure because you didn't set a time.
Oh, so, all right. Let's round this up.
We kind of just started.
2 minutes. 2 minutes, so it's 4, 6, and 9.
If I had to guess, we'd be somewhere around 18 to 20 minutes, I would assume. But we could be a little bit more, and I just lost track.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, we completed half of this. I'm okay for now. End it here. Wow, that looks like a fucking face. Mask, I mean. Doesn't it?
It's the alien staring back at us in shame.
It can't be. It could be like a, you know, the vagina womb thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, what do you turn it sideways? It's a fish. End it here, narrator. And
there you have it, racers. Tune in next time for Doug and Captain K play Hotel Dusk. Summer Vibes, Horizon Zero Chase Turbo. Wow. Okay.